This video will guide you through some steps to increase your QNAP NAS security. Security is not a fixed point and you will never be able to say that your NAS is completely secure. Security should be understood as a process. For this reason, this guide does not claim to be a complete guide for QNAP NAS security, but it will give you some useful instructions. Please have a look at the video description if you like to jump to a specific topic. In the first step, we decrease the attack surface for our NAS by deactivating unused services. This can be done by accessing the control panel and by navigating to system status. Now I select system services to get an overview about all running services. Now you can go through the list and deactivate an unused service. I will do it for FTP. I only use SFTP on port 22 and do not need the unencrypted version on port 21. In the control panel, I use the search to jump to the FTP options. In this dialog, I deactivate FTP. The pre-installed apps are another attack surface. You should go through them and uninstall the ones you do not use. This can be achieved by opening the App Center. In the example, I will uninstall the music station. You should continue uninstalling apps which are unused. The latest attack on QNAP devices could succeed because users use weak passwords for the administrator account. Make sure your password is generated by your password manager. Another recommendation is to deactivate the admin account and create a copy of it with a complicated and not too easy to guess username. To do so, go to the user management and create a new user. Add this user to the administrators group and give it sufficient permissions to access the network shares and all applications. Try to log on with this user and deactivate the admin account with this new admin user. QNAP offers two-factor authentication for the login. Before you can activate it, you must make sure that the time settings are correct and NTP should be enabled. The NTP option can be found in the control panel, system, and then general settings. At the top, you can now change to the time option and make sure that NTP is activated and the NTP server is reachable. Now you are prepared for the two-factor authentication. In the following steps, you will get a secret which is meant for the Google Authenticator or any other app who can deal with TOTP codes. Make sure to backup the secret. I will only show the steps performed on the NAS. Click on your username and got two options. Jump to two-step verification. Click on Get Started. Scan the QR code with your Google Authenticator app. And the next step, you have to enter the code which has been generated on your mobile phone. The next step asks you for a security question or a mail address. In my opinion, this renders the second factor useless, but you can still give a wrong answer to the question and secure it safely on your password manager. To make it harder for sniffers in the network, make sure that SSL is activated and make also sure that you are using it in your browser for login. To do so, enter HTTPS before your NAS IP in the browser and append the SSL port to the address. You will get an error because your certificate is self-signed. Just ignore it. The next hint looks obvious, but on Reddit, I could see users complaining about the malware attack on their NAS, which used a really old firmware version. Your NAS will inform you about new firmware versions and ask you to update. Despite several glitches in the last year and a lot of reworked firmwares, for security reasons you have to be up to date to be protected against threats. If you do not get firmware updates for your device because the end of support is reached, you should not open up any ports to the internet and only operate it in a secure environment which is firewall protected. QNAP offers an antivirus solution. I do not have too much trust in it, but nevertheless it is also a good idea to keep it up to date. The name of the app is Malware Remover and you can update it in the App Center. By the way, you should always keep all installed apps up to date to make sure that you are not at risk against known security issues in these applications. If your NAS is running services which are open to the internet, you can add a layer of obfuscation by not using the standard ports. In the example, I changed to port for the HTTPS connection. This trick applies to all other services which run on standard ports. QNAP offers network access protection to be safe against brute force attacks. To activate it, go to Control Panel, Security, and then to Network Access Protection. The next thing is not to use my QNAP cloud service. In my opinion, QNAP is not trustworthy when it comes to security, and my QNAP cloud is like a honeypot for attackers. But this is just my personal opinion. The next thing may look obvious, but it should not be missed. Put a firewall between your NAS device and the internet. In my case, it's a simple router. In the control panel, you will find system logs. You should have the connection logs activated to make sure that you can trace attackers. If the connection logs are disabled, you are blind in case of an attack. If you want to access your NAS from the internet and not only from the local network, you should think twice before you open up a port in your firewall. I decided to access my NAS via the integrated VPN server. This makes it possible to get access to all NAS services by only opening a single port. This may help to decrease the attack surface. This list is, of course, not complete, and you will find some other ideas in the video description. Please comment if you have something to add.